a hierarchical list of detector geometry that can be folded at any level, checkboxes that can be used to turn on and off individual volumes and trajectories, objects to rotate, buttons to push to zoom in and out, bars to pull to pan, right-click menus, tools for measurement, directly on canvas, and ways to navigate through different events. This is my favorite GM4 visualization tool. Stay with me to learn how to enable and use it. It is overwhelming for a new user of GM4 to see such a long list of visualization methods listed in the official GM4 menu. I commented on the pros and cons of a few of them based on my personal experience in my own GM4 application Gears website. I also walked through them in a YouTube video published 3 years ago. Many new users prefer to use the pretty visualization that comes together with the Qt-based graphic user interface, but Qt is not enabled by default in a regular GM4 installation. On the other hand, HapRep file can be generated by any GM4 installation in all three major operating systems. You do need a separate HapRep file viewer, HapRep data browser, to visualize HapRep files generated by your GM4 simulation. It is based on Java. That's why it is cross-platforms. However, it is based on an old Java version 1.8. which is also known as Java 8. One of the three long-term supporting versions of Java. The latest update of Java 8 is already too new to run that old HapRep file viewer in a Windows machine. Fortunately, a slightly outdated version of Java 1.8 is still used in CentOS Linux version 8. I created a Docker container which includes HapRep on Java 1.8 CentOS 8. The usage of it is detailed in the Docker Hub webpage. On a Windows machine, you need to install a program called Mobile Xterm, which provides something called an X11 server. Basically, it is a program that allows Linux graphic programs to be shown on a Windows desktop. Once it is up and running on your Windows, you don't have to push any button on its window, as the only thing we need from this program is an X11 server, which is already running on the background if this program is running. You also need to have your Docker desktop up and running. Check its icon in the notification area to confirm that. If you don't know what is a Docker desktop, please check my playlist about containers. Parameters used to launch the HapRep container are saved in a text file called docker-compose.yml in the Gears package. You can download the zipped Gears package from this website, extract its content to anywhere you like, get into the folder. You should be able to see the docker-compose.yml file. To use this file, you need to open a terminal in this folder. On Windows, simply highlight the address bar, type PowerShell and return. In the popped-up Windows PowerShell terminal, type docker-compose run HapRep. And you should be able to see the HapRep window popping up. The RM option is optional. This is used to automatically remove the created container after its usage. Click Open Data and then Open HapRap file. You should be able to see the Gears folder, which is visible both in the container and in the host operating system. In my previous video, Containerize GM4, I explained how to use a GM4 container to run a GM4 program called Gears, which will create 10 HapRap files for you to view. These files, again, are visible in both the container and the host OS. When you click Next Event, the viewer will automatically load the next HapRap file that has a larger index number in the same folder. The HapRap files are created by these four lines of GM4 macro commands. If you want to overlay all 10 events in one canvas, add one more line to your macro file. And this is the result. To sum up, the HapRap viewer shows frames of individual volumes, which allows you to see through many layers of volumes. It provides a list of volumes that can be turned on and off on canvas. Trajectories shown on canvas can also be turned on and off. It allows you to measure distance between any two points on canvas. The problem is that it only works on an old version of Java, which is not available anymore in many modern operating systems. However, a Docker container has been created to keep it usable in three major operating systems.